on the sea when it starts to get really windy and wavy. Well, one day Jesus was on a boat and it got a huge storm, a big tormenta. And Jesus, all he did was say, "Peace, be still." And the tormenta stopped. It was no more. Also, Jesus had a friend, his name was Lazarus, who died. 3 days after his death, Jesus came to Lazarus and he said, "He's not dead, just sleeping. Lazarus, come out." And Lazarus came back to life and walked out of the tomb. So Jesus, he could control the weather. Jesus was able to raise people from the dead. He could do all of these special things because he was Jesus Christ, the Son of God. He was God. And most people were super excited. They really wanted to know who Jesus was and wanted to listen to him. But there were some people who were not excited. They did not want to know who Jesus was. They did not want Jesus to keep doing his miracles. They did not want anything to do with Jesus. And you know what? These people were the religious leaders. That's right. They were the people who above all should have been the ones who were happy to see Jesus. But no, they were not. They were not happy to see Jesus. And do you know why? Excuse me for a moment. They were not happy to see Jesus because they knew that they only said they loved God. They didn't actually love God, not with their hearts. They said it with their lips, but not with their hearts. And they knew that Jesus knew that they were lying, that they were hypocrites. Do you know what a hypocrite is? A hypocrite is someone who says one thing, but they don't mean it. They mean something else. Or they say that they'll do something, but they don't, they do something else. That's a hypocrite. So these religious leaders were hypocrites, and they did not like Jesus. So they decided they wanted to get rid of Jesus. They wanted to stop feeling bad for the bad thoughts they had, for the bad things they were doing. So one day, they got together and they got a plan. They said, "We are going to get Jesus arrested. We're going to get the Romans to arrest Jesus, to put him on trial, and to kill him. That will get rid of our problem. We won't have a problem with Jesus after that anymore." So that was their plan. And one day, they went to the Garden of Gethsemane is what it was called, where Jesus and his disciples were. They got the Romans to arrest him and take him to Pilate. Pilate was the governor. And the governor was the one who would say whether or not Jesus needed to be put to death. They put on a trial. They had him before the jueces, before the judges. But all the things that they said, there wasn't anything to convict Jesus of. Remember, Jesus is perfect. He never did anything wrong. So they had people lie about him. But the lies weren't even the same. But still, they had people lie about him. And in the end, they just said, "Well, he claims to be God, and he cannot possibly be God." So that is something called blasphemy, a horrible sin, claiming to be God when you are not. So he should be put to death. And so they got all the people, all those people who just before had loved Jesus and wanted him to heal them, they got them to turn against Jesus. And they got them to call for his crucifixion. A crucifixion was a death that was horrible. You would be nailed to a cross, your hands and your feet, and you'd be hanging on that piece of wood from just your hands and your feet. And you died in pain, and you died by not being able to breathe because your body would become so tired that you couldn't breathe anymore after hanging for days by your arms and by your legs. That would be very, very painful, right? It was one of the worst deaths you could give someone. Well, Pilate, he realized that Jesus hadn't done anything wrong and tried to get the people to release him, but they didn't want to because of the religious leaders. They got them to turn against Jesus. They called out, "Crucify him." And so that is what Pilate
decided to do. So about 9 o'clock in the morning, Jesus was hung on the cross with two others. These were thieves. They had been convicted of stealing. And so Jesus was hung with them. They put to make fun of Jesus because Jesus claimed to be God, the King of the Jews. They made a crown for him, a corona, but it was of thorns. And so they pressed it into his forehead and it made him bleed. They also whipped him and beat him. You saw in our last picture, I'll put it closer so maybe you can see better, how Jesus has their markings on him because they were beating him. And so now he was on the cross. But as Jesus hung there and the people were mocking him, teasing him, and saying horrible things to him, the guards there at the foot of his cross gambled away his clothes that he had. They had put a purple robe on him because purple is the color of royalty. And so they were making fun of him that he claimed to be king. And they gambled away his purple robe. Well, there was one thief on the cross, and he recognized who Jesus was. And he asked Jesus to remember him. And Jesus, seeing that this thief believed who he was and knew he was God, he told that thief, "You will be with me in paradise." So you know what that means? That means that that thief was going to go to heaven because he realized he had done something wrong. He had done bad things, and he needed to be saved, and he knew that Jesus was the one to save him. And so Jesus knew that and told him that he was saved. His name got written that day in the Lamb's Book of Life. So Jesus, that day, he died on the cross. But it wasn't a death like other people die. It was very, very different. You see, Jesus, as he was hanging there, cried out with a loud voice, "It is finished." And he chose to give up his life. Death didn't kill him. No one could kill him. He gave up his life. Many times, dying on a cross like this took hours or days. Days. It was a horrible death. It took a long time. But Jesus, it only took a couple hours because he chose to give up his life. And even though it was midday, the whole entire sky went black. And people knew, oh, something special has just happened. And in the temple, there was a curtain that divided two parts of the temple. One part of the temple was called the Holy of Holies. And only the priests could go there once they had cleansed themselves, because this was a special place. And that was the place that they would go to pray and pray for the people. Well, after Jesus died, that curtain, God ripped it from top to bottom that very moment, because now people can go directly to God because of what Jesus did. You see, Jesus died on the cross to pay for our sins. Remember what we talked about yesterday with that lamb? How the lamb was totally innocent, but it was killed so that it could cover Adam and Eve. Jesus was perfectly innocent. Jesus died to cover our sins. Because we are sinners, we cannot go to heaven like we are. We have to have our sins paid for, and we can't pay for our sins because there's nothing that we could do that would ever be good enough to pay for all the bad things that we've done. Only Jesus could do it. So we have to pray and ask Jesus to save us from our sins. We have to accept what he's already done. He's already forgiven our sins. All we have to do is accept it. So if you have never done that, this is all you need to do. I'm going to show you what you can say. Now, it's not these words that save you. It's believing in your heart and accepting Jesus' sacrifice. But this is something, if you don't know what to say, this is something you could say. Bow your heads, close your eyes. Dear Jesus, thank you so much for your sacrifice on the cross. Thank you for dying in my place. Lord, I know I'm a sinner and I've done bad things. Please forgive me. I accept you into my heart as my Savior. In your name I pray. Amen. already prayed something like that, or maybe you prayed just now, God has written your name in the Lamb's Book of Life, and nobody can take your name out. Isn't that a wonderful thing? You are saved forever. It doesn't matter what you do, you are on your way to heaven. So when you die, or if Jesus comes back, that is where you go, and that is a wonderful thing. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. I'm praying for you. I hope you have a great week as well. I love you guys so much. Bye, till next time.